Although Camelot succeeded My Fair Lady in Fritz Lowe's Broadway career, there was something in between, a Hollywood musical based on a story by the French novelist Colette. Like the novel it came from, the picture was called Gigi and included a song which was nothing but trouble. After it was shot, Fritz and Alan Lerner decided it looked and sounded so bad that it would have to be done again. The studio, anguished at the thought of spending $300,000 on reshooting one song, refused. So Lerner and Lowe offered to buy the entire picture from the studio for $3 million, which, by the way, they didn't have. The studio backed down, forked out the $300,000, and the song was reshot. It became a classic. I wish I could remember what it was called.
We met at 9.
We met at 8.
I was on time.
No, you were late.
I guess. I remember it well. We dined with friends.
We dined alone.
A tenor sang.
A baritone.
Ah, yes. I remember this well. That dancing April.
Oh,
And somehow I foolishly wonder if you might, by some chance, be thinking of it too. That carriage ride.
You walked me home.
You lost a glove.
I lost a comb.
Ah, yes. I remember it well. That brilliant sky.
We had some rain.
Those Russian songs.
From sunny Spain.
Ah, yes. I remember it well.
The difference of opinion between Lerner and Lowe on the subject of On the Street Where You Live, well, the same thing happened with another song in My Fair Lady, only the other way round. Lerner hated it, saying it sounded like a cello solo. Fritz loved it, saying it sounded like a cello solo, but a very good one. Lerner won the argument, and the song was dropped from the show into the bottom drawer. Sometime later, the partners were short of a song for Gigi to sing to her cat. Out came the cello solo, and into Gigi it went. Helen will sing Say a Prayer for Me Tonight. Colm follows this with one of the more fanciful songs from Fritz Lowe's score for a musical about the Wild West, Paint Your Wagon. And finally, the magnificent song with which Henry Higgins took his leave of us in My Fair Lady. The last song in the show, and perhaps the best. That'll be sung by Patricia Routledge.
Bow your head and please stay on your knees. accustomed to his fate. He almost makes the day begin. I've grown accustomed to the tune. He whistles night and noon. His smile, his frown, his up, his down. Second nature to me now, like breathing out and breathing in. I was serenely independent and content before we met. Surely I could always be that way again. And yet I've grown accustomed to his look, accustomed to his voice. I've grown accustomed to his face. He almost makes the day begin. I thought so used to hear him say.
After Camelot, Fritz Lowe retired from the theatre. He'd not been in the best of health for some time, and during the run of My Fair Lady, he'd suffered a coronary and been rushed into an oxygen tent. When he finally regained consciousness, the first thing he said was, "God damn it, that son of a bitch Lerner got all my house seats." Fritz died in his 87th year in February 1987. He'll always be remembered for his worldly optimism, his slapstick approach to life, but above all, for the haunting grace of his melodies. He had the authentic Viennese thistledown touch and was probably at his best writing the sort of tremulous celebrations of life that those of us in paroxysms of love can always be relied upon to indulge in. We say goodnight with this tune from My Fair Lady, which might be haunted just a little by the ghosts of Frederick Lowe's childhood in Vienna.
I could have died. I could have danced all night and still have begged for more.
I could have spread my wings and done a thousand things I've never done before.
I'll never know.
When she began to dance with me, I could have danced, danced, danced all night.
Thank you.